You're watching Reality Check. Now, in this time of the coronavirus lockdown, government after government, both center and states, are promoting the mantra of digital classrooms, of basically online education, as a way of ensuring that children don't lose out during a time when schools across India are still shut and there's a lack of clarity of when they will open. But is this digital classroom a reality? Or is it a mantra in a country where millions and millions of Indians do not have access to the internet or to the digital world? My colleague Mariam Alavi and I traveled to a small basti, a small village outside Patna in Bihar for a reality check.
Rajesh Kumar.
Rajanti Kumar. Nandri Kumar.
An hour outside Patna, we meet children from Madhuban village.
Aap sab 8 mein hai.
The oldest is 14, the youngest 6.
Kya pad rahe ho?
Kaka guys.
Kaka guys pad rahe ho?
In the ordinary course, they would have been at class at the nearby government school, now closed for almost 3 months.
Ye abhi school sab band hai. Aapke kitne dinon se band hai?
22
मार्च से बंद है तो कोई क्लास नहीं चल रहा
नहीं। आप कौन सी क्लास में पढ़ते हैं
एट
में अच्छा
क्या नाम है आपका
सतीश कुमार
The Bihar government has introduced an app called Vidyavahini from which children can download school books from the 1st to the 12th standard. But to access it needs smartphones and good net connections.
ऑनलाइन के लिए जैसे कहते हैं कि आपके पास वो होना चाहिए कुछ फोन या जिससे वो डाउनलोड हाँ। करने के लिए तो उस किस्म का फोन है
नहीं है
नहीं
नहीं
है, नहीं है।
आपके पास है
यस
अच्छा
तो मिल जाता है उस पे फोन पे ठीक डाउनलोड कर पाते हैं
हाँ डाउनलोड कर पाते हैं
अच्छा
क्या डाउनलोड किया आपने
अभी तो कुछ नहीं किया है पर पता रहेगा तो कर लेंगे
लेकिन आपके पास वो नहीं है कितनों के पास यहाँ वो है
इंटरनेट वाले फोन किसके पास है
वो जो स्मार्टफोन जिसे कहते हैं कितनों के पास है हाथ खड़ा करके बताइए आप बता रही हैं आपका है
किसी के पास इंटरनेट वाला फोन है
नहीं
किसके पास नहीं है बताइए हाथ खड़ा करके स्मार्टफोन हाथ खड़ा करके बताओ अच्छा
किसी के पास नहीं है
किसी के पास भी नहीं है
नहीं।
वो फोन क्या आपके मम्मी पापा के पास है या किन के पास
पापा भी रख ले रहते हैं कभी घर पे भी छोड़ देते हैं कि पता रहेगा तब कुछ
आपने इंटरनेट यूज किया है फोन पे
हाँ।
क्या किस लिए यूज किया है क्या किया था फोन पे
कुछ ऐसे देखने
वीडियो देखे थे गाना सुना था क्या किया था
वीडियो गाना है कभी मेहंदी डिजाइन सब देखते थे
अच्छा मेहंदी डिजाइन
अच्छा
तो कभी इससे पहले लेकिन पढ़ाई का कुछ देखे है उस पे कि ये क्या है कोई डाउट जब आया हो वो कभी देखे है इंटरनेट पे
नहीं
वो कैसे करते हैं पता है
नहीं पता
सिग्नल आ जाता है लेकिन मोबाइल का मतलब वीडियो वगैरह देखने का
हाँ।
टावर मिल जाता है
टावर यहाँ उतना नहीं मिलता है
टावर इतना नहीं मिलता है यहाँ पे
आई थिंक वी आरसेल्व्स
आर गेटिंग अ सिंगल बार हियर
सो इट कम्स एंड गोज
Earlier, while we were getting off the car, I was finding it difficult to connect to the net. But at this spot right here,
there's a little bit of connection.
Yeah.
We meet the children through a group that works for the rights of Bihar's scheduled caste communities. They run a learning center for these children.
जैसे सरकार कह रही है कि लॉकडाउन में जो भी जिनकी शिक्षा बैक जा रहा है वो ऑनलाइन पढ़ाई करें तो बेसिक चीज़ है सर कि हमारे समाज में ऐसे लोग हैं कि अभी ऑनलाइन का मतलब ही नहीं समझते हैं कि ऑनलाइन पढ़ाई होते कैसे है तो सरकार ऑलरेडी वेबसाइट पे अपने जो भी है क्या बोलते हैं एनआरसी के हाँ एनसीईआरटी के पूरे बुक डाल दिया है कि लोग निकालें और पढ़ें तो जैसे कि हम लोग हमारे यहाँ कोई बच्चा इसके बाद समझता ही नहीं है
इन पटना वी मीट बिहार्स एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर
जैसे अब स्कूल्स वगैरह की जो भी चर्चा हो रही है कि डिजिटल ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन की जो बात की जा रही है तो ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन का सिर्फ एक ये सवाल है कि बहुत सारे लोग खासकर जो मतलब गरीब तबके और उस तबके के लोग हैं उनके पास एक्सेस नहीं है कि सेलफोन और उन चीज़ों से जिससे वो डाउनलोड कर सकें ये सारे
अभी एक ये और भी हम लोगों ने किया है कि ये जो दूरदर्शन के माध्यम से क्लास 1 से 12 तक का उसका कोर्स चला रहे हैं हम लोग और उसके बाद सारी किताबों को हम लोगों ने ऑनलाइन कर दिया है एक ऐप के ऐप पर
जी।
उसकी जानकारी सब लोगों को दे दी गई है और दूरदर्शन के माध्यम से जो क्लासेस चल रहे हैं, हमने व्यक्तिगत रूप से एक दिन बैठ करके देख रहे थे, बहुत संतोषजनक था। तो ये सब काम हम लोग लॉकडाउन पीरियड में भी शिक्षा को कंटिन्यू,
दूरदर्शन से बच्चा मतलब सीखने की उसकी कितनी इच्छा,
भाई फिलहाल के तो आप यही कर सकते थे, हम लोग
जी
क्लासेज हम लोग खोल नहीं सकते
जी,
तो उसकी वैकल्पिक व्यवस्था में हम लोगों ने यही किया और इसके माध्यम से बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं।
आप लोगों के घर यहाँ घर पे टीवीयां हैं?
नहीं,
नहीं। आपके यहाँ नहीं है?
नहीं।
तुम्हारे हैं बेटा?
है।
अच्छा, ऐसा कुछ आ रहा है क्लास वगैरह देखने लायक?
नहीं
नहीं। आप लोग कोई टीवी पे क्लास वगैरह, टीवी है किसी के आपके घर में?
हाँ।
है, बट उस पे क्लास वगैरह नहीं चल रहा है।
It's not as if these children are any less eager to learn or have lesser ambitions than their privileged counterparts.
तो स्कूल बंद है, अच्छा लग रहा है, मजे आ रहे हैं या बुरा लग रहा है?
बुरा लग रहा है।
बुरा लग रहा है, क्यों बताओ?
क्योंकि अब पहले पढ़ते थे स्कूल में, कुछ जानते थे, कुछ नहीं जा रहा है, जो भी याद कर रहे सब भुला जा रहे हैं।
अच्छा, जो याद किए सब भुला जा रहे हैं। तो आपको क्या पढ़ाई में अच्छा कौन सा लगता था, कौन सा सब्जेक्ट अच्छा पसंद है आपको?
साइंस।
आपको?
इंग्लिश,
हिंदी,
मैथ।
इंग्लिश, हिंदी,
मैथ।
अच्छा,
मैथ
अच्छा लगता था आपको।
आप लोग क्या बनना चाहते थे?
कुछ सोचा है?
कुछ सोचा है क्या बनेंगे आगे?
थी पुलिस बनने के लिए सोचे हैं।
पुलिस बनना है? और आप?
हम आर्मी ऑफिसर बनना चाहते हैं।
आर्मी ऑफिसर,
पुलिस।
अच्छा, क्यों भाई सब लड़ाई करने का मन है क्या? आप दीदी क्या सोचा है अभी?
इंजीनियर बनेंगे।
बहुत अच्छी बात है।
डॉक्टर
अभी नहीं सोचा है?
इंजीनियर, पुलिस।
आप भी पुलिस में भर्ती होंगे?
इन बिहार विद मरियम अलवी एंड कैमरा पर्सन मनु नायर, श्रीनिवासन जैन फॉर NDTV।
All right, joining me tonight, we go to panel, but let me begin with Govind Singh Dotasara, who's the Education Minister of Rajasthan. And I spoke to him earlier and I began by asking him the same question that I put to the Bihar Education Minister. Govind Singh ji, ye bataiye ki aap bhi online education ki baat Rajasthan mein kar rahe hain, aap bhi keh rahe hain ki classes doordarshan pe honge, lekin aise kitne bache hain jinke paas Rajasthan mein smartphones hain ya doordarshan se seekh sakte hain?
जी, निश्चित रूप से जब कोरोना संक्रमण आया अचानक से तो हमारी पढ़ाई बाधित हुई, हमारी परीक्षाएं भी बच्चों की स्थगित हो गई और हमारे लिए एक चैलेंज हो गया कि हम हमारे बच्चों को घर में बैठे को कैसे एजुकेशन दे पाएंगे। तो इसके लिए हमारे राजस्थान सरकार ने, शिक्षा विभाग ने एक कवायद की और स्माइल प्रोजेक्ट के माध्यम से व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप से हमारे टीचर्स को जोड़ने का काम किया और टीचर के साथ साथ अभिभावक और बच्चों के पास जिनके पास में एंड्रॉयड फ़ोन है उनको व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप से जोड़ करके हमने उनको कंटेंट्स डालने का काम किया।
नहीं, लेकिन जी नहीं, मेरा ये कहना था कि एंड्रॉयड फ़ोन्स लेकिन कितने बच्चों के पास होगा?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, वो कम लोग थे, 20,000-30,000 टीचर जुड़े, जो 80,000 बच्चे जुड़े, लेकिन उसके बाद में हमने जावड़ेकर जी को पत्र लिखा, सूचना और प्रसारण केंद्रीय मंत्री जी को, और हमने कहा कि भाई रेडियो बहुत जगह मिल जाता है और दूरदर्शन जो DD न्यूज है ये भी मैं समझता हूँ मिल जाता है, तो इस दिशा में हम आगे बढ़े। पहले हमें केवल आकाशवाणी के लिए 25, रेडियो स्टेशन के लिए उन्होंने फ्री में 55 मिनट का प्रतिदिन का स्लॉट दिया और उसके बाद में दूरदर्शन को कुछ से पेमेंट लेकर के हमको 3.5 घंटे का पेमेंट दिया।
बट दूरदर्शन भी यही सवाल है कि टीवी क्या कितने लोगों के पास है, क्या है इतना टीवी कवरेज?
नहीं, निश्चित रूप से मानता हूं मैं, लेकिन जो हमने प्रयास किया, जो हम तात्कालिक रूप से कर सकते थे, देश में किसी भी स्टेट में ये प्रयास नहीं हुआ, राजस्थान की ओर से हमने प्रयास किया कि रेडियो के ऊपर भी हमने बच्चों को पढ़ाने का काम किया और दूरदर्शन पे भी किया, लेकिन मैं समझता हूं कि अगर इस तरीके की ये महामारी लंबी खींचती है, हम स्कूल नहीं खोल पाते हैं, तो हमारा जो RTE, जो हमारा कानून है जिसको अनिवार्य रूप से हमें बच्चों को जो शिक्षा देनी है उसमें मैं समझता हूँ बाधा पहुँचती है, और इसके लिए अब हमने PAB में जो केंद्र सरकार को हम मानव संसाधन मंत्रालय को जो हमारा प्लान लेकर के जाते हैं उस प्लान में हम कई तरह के प्रोजेक्ट लेकर के जा रहे हैं कि अगर इस तरह की दिक्कत आती है कि ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन की तरफ हमें जाना पड़ेगा तो हम लोग केंद्र सरकार से ये चाहेंगे कि वो प्रोजेक्ट को मंजूरी दे, हमें केंद्र सरकार सहायता दे, पैसा दे।
तो मंत्री जी क्या फिर बताइए आप कैसे करेंगे, क्या ये सारे जो बच्चे हैं उनको आप कोई फोन्स या टैबलेट्स बांटेंगे?
नहीं, हम इस प्रकार के प्रोजेक्ट लेके जा रहे हैं कि कोई इस तरीके के टैबलेट्स या जो उपकरण आते हैं जिसके माध्यम से बहुत कम खर्चा उसका होता है और केवल वही कंटेंट्स जो यहाँ से हम शाला दर्पण के माध्यम से या हमारे एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट जो है वो अगर उन कंटेंट्स को डालेगा तो केवल वही बच्चे देख पाएंगे और वो चीज़ पढ़ पाएंगे और वो प्रत्येक विद्यार्थी के पास में उपलब्धता सरकारें कराएँ। ये प्रयास जब तक नहीं होगा तब तक ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन का कोई मायना नहीं रहे। आप देखिए जैसे नेट की सुविधा है लेकिन वो बच्चे क्या पढ़ रहे हैं, क्या देख रहे हैं, वो साथ में एजुकेशन के नाम से कहीं कोई पिक्चर तो नहीं देख रहे हैं, नेट पे और कुछ तो नहीं देख रहे हैं, गेम तो नहीं खेल रहे हैं। तो ये सब चीज़ें वास्तव में चैलेंज है लेकिन जो आज जो परिस्थितियां बनी है उसके अंदर जो हमने बेस्ट करने की चेष्टा की है वो बेस्ट किया है लेकिन अब आगे भी हम केंद्र सरकार को अभी 18 तारीख को हम जो हमारा प्लान लेकर के जा रहे हैं उसमें हम इस तरह की व्यवस्था लेके जा रहे हैं, प्रोजेक्ट लेके जा रहे हैं कि उन बच्चों को जो खेत डाणी खलियान में गरीब का बेटा बैठा है उसको भी ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन मिले। जी,
ऑल्सो ज्वाइनिंग अस ऑन द शो वी हैव आतिशी विद अस, लीडर ऑफ द आम आदमी पार्टी, वी हैव बिक्रम दौलत सिंह हु इज एमडी ऑफ सेंट्रल स्क्वायर फाउंडेशन व्हिच आल्सो वर्क्स ऑन ग्रासरूट्स एजुकेशन, एंड अंजलि मोदी, फ्रीलांस जर्नलिस्ट हु इज रिटन ऑन एजुकेशन इन इंडिया फॉर मेनी इयर्स। Thank you all so much for joining us. Atishi, if I can just start with you, the same challenges in Delhi as well. I know that the assumption is that in urban environments, children, even those who are from lower income groups, may have greater access to phones and so on. But is that true? And what's been your experience in Delhi and with the Delhi schools and trying to make this switch to this kind of digital mantra?
So I think, Srinivasan, the situation is likely to be better in Delhi than maybe in rural Bihar, rural Rajasthan or rural Jharkhand. But even in a place like Delhi, at least half the students who come to Delhi government schools don't have access to Android phones within their families. And so the idea that we can substitute face-to-face education with online education is definitely a flawed idea. And yes, some of the older students who might be in grade 11 and 12 may have access to online devices like phones, tablets, etc. But I think a vast majority of the children still do not have access.
Okay.
And so when we started running some of our programs for the lower grades, we extensively run programs on foundation skills, reading, maths, etc. in the early months of every academic year. So we have actually run them through SMSs, missed calls and IVRs.
Okay.
Whereby we have been sending activities for children to do. It's only for older children in 11th and 12th grade that we ran online classes.
IVR is through normal phones. Right.
Yes. But I would be, no one has been prepared for a pandemic like this. And I think this is a situation the world is encountering for the first time. And if schools cannot be reopened, then I think there will be a very serious need to rethink how is it that we are educating our children. Because I don't think online education can be a way for mass education.
Atishi, what do you think? I mean, I know again we're in uncharted waters here, but very briefly, what could be a way out of this?
So I again, as I said, cannot
in the event
for,
that this
many
continues
other,
and,
for yeah. many other for many for the rural hinterland, I can't say, but I think that at least for a place like Delhi, television is definitely a better solution than online education, because I think that access to television, at least in urban India, is far more universal.
Right.
So I think that if we were to run classes where children can watch on television, that could possibly be one solution, definitely a more accessible solution than online education.
Right. Okay. Anjali Modi, you know, while of course it's I don't think it would be anyone's case that given what you've just heard that online education can really become this new kind of mantra, especially when you move outside cities. But then what solutions could there be, especially in the rural hinterland? Because if you're not, if you're going to be in a position where you can't really reopen schools, how are children going to be able to learn?
Okay, one, I'd like to pick up on something that Atishi says. She's right about, you know, cities being a little bit different from rural areas, but not that much, because even the Delhi government's online classes for class 11 and 12 had very, very low attendance, if, you know, which is what people look at. So, for instance, you know, only something like 30% of class 11 students have been attending the maths classes. It's below 40% for English. So, and it's not simply having a mobile phone or a smartphone. It's also the nature of the interaction. Students actually don't find it useful, or they don't have the time, or they don't have net connectivity or a million things. I think the other thing that Atishi said, which is something that all governments should really be thinking about, is the digital divide that we're talking about is really, you know, just the latest expression of a very iniquitous system, right? Our education system is not designed for the majority of India's children. It never was. And what this online schooling business is doing is it's actually showing that up. Now, what I found interesting about your interactions with students in Bihar was that here were children who were actually, you know, meeting with each other. They were able to interact with each other, and nobody's actually thought about a village by village solution, right? Now, there's been somebody who you know, school education cannot be decided in the capital city. It has to be decided by a community. And I think it is community solutions that we have to be looking for as we go forward.
So that's really that's going to be the way forward. Okay. Okay. Bikram Daulat Singh, what do you make of this? And what do you think could be, based on your own experiences of you know, the schools and the children institutions you work with, to surmount this challenge of how to teach children in a country which is so digitally divided?
Yeah, so Srinivasan, I think we're in uncharted territory, but I think the positive side of this is that we need to recognize that till COVID, all innovation and funding around EdTech was actually focused on a sliver of some 10 million children in India, what we call India One, out of more than 260 million children. And this was really because of a lot of the current EdTech in products not being affordable, challenges around availability of products in vernacular languages, lack of evidence of what works. But COVID is, of course, tragic, led to unprecedented disruption of learning for 260 million children over across 1.5 million schools. But it's also potentially a sputtering moment for EdTech, as finally there's no choice but to replicate the learning process through digital education. And what we are finding is that the national government, state governments, and the ed ecosystem are stepping up to meet the challenge. And for example, Diksha, which is, you know, the government platform for school education to disseminate digital learning content, has had 10 million downloads and now is the number one top free education app in India. There have been 46 million content plays just in April and May, which is like half of last year. Diksha has almost set up this digital highway now, through which a lot of high quality content is being disseminated. TikTakly, you know, just to give an example, TikTak Learn is a video library that has been created free by Center Square Foundation and Google. And, you know, now it's being, you know, accessed by 11 state governments, and we've almost had 12 million views in just 11 weeks of launch. And, you know, and we heard from the Ed Minister of Rajasthan, but several state governments...
But, you know, Bikram... I mean, in isolation, those sounds like big numbers, but in the context of a country like India, that's... those are very limited numbers, no? And as we know, the macro data about internet connectivity and smartphone usage is still very poor.
Yeah, no, a couple of things I want to say. I think you're right. It's early stages in a lot of these programs. Many states have, launched holistic programs. And I just wanted to call out that, you know, two, three features, you know, so people are being thoughtful. The first is they're trying to integrate all these digital learning materials to the curriculum that the child was anyway supposed to consume. They're now increasingly looking at low-tech channels, you know, which we heard from the Education Minister of Rajasthan, IVRS, TV, radio. So I'll tell you, for example, UP. 90% of teachers in UP have formed WhatsApp groups with their students. So 25 lakh students across the state are now connected with their teacher on WhatsApp. So, you know, a lot of material is being shared. Doordarshan, we heard, you know, in UP, you know, now there was a 1.5-hour slot. This increased to 4 hours. increasingly we are also, you know, of course there's a challenge around reach, and we're finding that now many states are also trying to track usage and low tech is probably the way to go, and you know, we feel there's a 2.0 low tech is the program.
But Atishi, give us a sense that in this time, as children are grappling with this whole uncertainty, trying to adapt to these newer ways of learning, what sort of impact is it actually having on children, and you know, all the work that was done in places like Delhi to really come quite a long way with education? What are the concerns about how this could push things back?
So I think we are definitely, as far as this corona pandemic is concerned, on uncharted territory on in every field, be it in the field of health, hospitals, economy, education, because the world has never really seen a crisis like this. So I think that definitely this would set children back. I think that especially for children who are coming into government schools, they're often coming from the poorest sections of society, often they're first generation learners. So their only access to educational material and exposure was coming from schools. So I think that, yes, there would be a setback, but I think that at this point of time, there is, I think there is also limited interventions that can be done. Online education, yes, is an intervention, but there's no doubt that there is a very serious digital divide. And television channels is an intervention that is available for urban areas, but then may not be available for rural areas. So as with many other domains, I think that if this pandemic was to continue, there will need to be a fundamental rethink as to how is it that we are teaching.
Okay. Anjali, so, I mean, what do you make of what... you know, Bikram was saying that there is, I mean, you know, there is a challenge, but at the same time, a lot of states are adapting to this digital mantra. There's a lot of downloads of these apps.
Well, firstly, I think governments in general are very obsessed with tech. So this is just an opportunity for, you know, civil servants who've in any case been sort of, you know, filling government school classrooms with smart boards. I mean, they may not have benches to sit on, but they have smart boards. They may not have an internet connection, but they have smart boards. So this is an opportunity for governments who've been looking at that sort of thing to buy into this idea. The figures that he's, you know, with all due respect, those numbers are really quite meaningless. A number like 90% of UP teachers having formed WhatsApp groups and connected with all their students. That's sort of, you know, I'd say to somebody who actually says that, what have you been smoking? Because have you been to the average UP school? Have you seen, you know, what happens over there? You know, the students actually attend, were attending regular school. I mean, yes, we, you know, this is an unprecedented time. We can, we have to rethink, but I think we have to rethink the whole education system. You know, is this top-down, one size fits all education system that's designed for a small minority of, you know, well-to-do, privileged people? Is that the education system that we must continue? I mean, this is an, actually an opportunity for us to step back and think. We're so obsessed with finishing the syllabus and
just
finishing
one
the
quick...
school year, that we're not actually thinking in terms of learning.
Okay, so I you're saying almost rethink, but just very quickly.
Not almost, do rethink.
Right, just very, very quickly in the end, Atishi. Rajasthan minister was even talking perhaps about the possibility of actually distributing tablets or even phones or some device where they can only access educational material. Is that something which is realistic at all?
I mean, I think that it is, it's a very large scale to be thinking about it. And it's also a large scale at a time when governments are going, all governments across the country are going through a very severe financial crisis and crunch. And for example, I mean, there's, for the 2 months of lockdown, there have been virtually no taxes that have come in. All governments are struggling just to make ends meet. So I'm not sure whether we will very soon be in a situation where tablets can be given to every student. As I said, I think there's no easy answers to this question. I think, yes, a lot of the things that Vikrama talked about are positive. I think it is that we are moving in that direction. But I think we are still a very long way from having very clear-cut answers about where the education system is going to go if we cannot reopen schools.
Okay. Okay, well, at least that's a candid admission of the scale of the challenge. But it's been fascinating. Thank you all so much for joining me on Reality Check. We're completely out of time. Thanks so much for watching. Good night.